It was a horrible situation. I was in the worst shape of my life. Passing out, shitting on myself, peeing blood. I got in the tub. I had this poncho liner on because in San Diego in November, it's chilly. So I'm freezing. She puts the water on me and I'm peeing what looks like dirt. It's just dark, dark, dark. It's like dirt coming out of me. And we have a discussion and she calls my mom up. My mom has a doctor friend. The doctor friend says, you got to get him to the hospital. His kidneys are shutting down. This is going on. This is going on. He could die. And this is where the story gets kind of crazy. It was the best and worst feeling I had in my life. I had put myself in a situation where I opened my mind to the fullest capacity to pull this off. And all the pain, I mean, it was live. The pain sensors were going to my body. I'm in this tub in the fetal position. The water's coming down on me. And I'm just sitting there, just jackhammering. Hot water hit me, I'm jackhammering. Peeing Coca-Cola out of me. I'm like, God, dog, I'm just... And she goes, we gotta get you to the hospital. It was the best feeling of my entire life. And everybody goes, how do you say that? I probably could have died. And I literally pushed myself to a place that very few human beings would ever be willing to go. And I got to examine myself. I call it the live autopsy, where we find out why someone died after they're dead. I got a chance in 19 hours and 6 minutes to put myself in the worst possible condition I could possibly be in and figure out how to get through it and get through it. And all this pain going through me was confirmation that I had just done something that I thought was humanly impossible. And I didn't want it to go away. Look what the human mind can do. And from that 19 hours and 6 minutes, I lived an entire lifetime, People live 100 years and never experience the highs, the lows, the journey I did, all of it. In 19 hours and 6 minutes, I lived 100 years. And I try hard to put it in the book, but no one will ever be able to really understand what that was about. And I was like, if I die here today, I'm fine with that.
I don't really like those words. Self-help or self-management or self-improvement. I don't really like what those words have come to mean these days, because there's a lot of people out there that are constantly trying to improve themselves by looking for the one change, right? The one change in their life that's gonna make their dreams come true. And even worse, on top of that, there's a lot of people out there, a lot of self-help gurus and these hyperactive motivational speakers and these other self-appointed modern Zen yoga warriors that they're trying to sell the one thing. They're trying to sell the 9 steps or the enlightened path that's going to allow you to unlock all of your human potential and fulfill the dreams so you can live the life that you've always wanted to live. I'm no guru. And I definitely don't claim to be. I'm just a man. But I will tell you this. It isn't one thing. And it isn't 10 things. And it isn't 100 things. It isn't a quick path. And there are no shortcuts. Meditation won't get you there. And neither will a miracle drug or an organic supplement or some superfood. Getting better isn't a hack or a trick or a one change that you need to make. Getting better is a campaign. It's a campaign. It's a daily, a weekly, it's an hourly fight. An incessant fight that doesn't stop against weakness and against temptation and against laziness. It's a campaign of discipline. It's a campaign of hard work and dedication. It's waking up early and going to bed late and grinding out every second in between. Every single day. So, you want to get better? You want to self-improve? Stop looking for a shortcut and go find your alarm clock. And find your discipline. And find your guts and your passion and your drive. And find your will. And then you will find your freedom.
Everybody has dreams, and and as much as you want to be able to listen a little bit, because somebody's going to give you a gem, but you, nobody knows but you. You can't get advice on what you should do with your life, right? Nobody knows what you are. Like, even sometimes you don't really even know what you are. You got to take your shot. And it's like, as much as you want people to agree and you want the people around you to be supporting your dreams and all, it's not going to be like that all the time. You got to do it alone. And people will help you. And when you get the ball rolling, people will jump on. But if you don't believe, nobody else is going to believe. People come along because your belief is so insane. That your belief is so strong that makes people be like, yo, this crazy asshole. Following your dreams is a lonely, solitary, scary, dangerous pursuit. You can't wait for somebody to think you can do it. Mm-hmm. And it's like, because they don't think you can do nothing they can't do.
Exactly. Bingo. Right?
You know what I mean? It's like, it's a lonely, scary, dangerous pursuit, and you got to be willing to risk everything to become that seed of what you believe
you
is in there. You got to be fearless. You got to be relentless.
The truth is, you don't have anything to give that you don't have. So you have to keep your own self full. That's your job. I say to my girls all of the time that your real work is to figure out where your power base is and to work on the alignment of your personality, your gifts that you have to give, with the real reason why you're here. That's the number one thing you have to do, is to work on yourself and to fill yourself up and keep your cup full. Keep yourself full. Now, I used to be afraid of that. I used to be afraid, particularly from people who say, oh, she's so full of herself. She's so full of herself. And now I embrace it. I consider it a compliment that I am full of myself. Because you only when you're full, I'm full, I'm overflowing. My cup runneth over. I have so much to offer and so much to give. And I am not afraid of honoring myself, you know. It's miraculous when you think about it. The ability to take care of that, to honor yourself and that which is greater than yourself, that which the reason for your being here. There's no selflessness in that, because only through that do you have the ability to offer yourself, your whole self, your full expression of who you are to the rest of the world. We'll be right back.